Hi, my name is Jamila Rowser, and I am a writer, creator, and community builder. And I'm a Black girl geek, and I love anime and comics. I grew up all around the world. My mom was in the military, she was in the Air Force. Both my parents are from the Bronx, so that's like my hometown. And now I live in Miami. My parents and I would fight over whose turn it was to read Harry Potter.
I believe it grew into her because she had no other choice but to share what the family loves as well.
And my mom loves Pokemon Go now, and we'll watch anime together. At the end of the day, it's really just about good stories, and that's what we love as a family, and I love that I'm able to share that with them. Right, Mama? The Girl Gone Geek blog is the origin story of all my creations, so that one is always gonna hold a special place in my heart. I wanted to write about something that I was really passionate about, which was geek culture.
When I met her, it was around the time where she was starting to see her potential to be a creator in this space and not just a commentator.
I started to become invited to be on podcasts and even panels like New York City Comic Con.
I used to see the responses that the people write back to her. I felt that she reached out to them.
With Geek Girl Brunch, I wanted to have a network and a safe space for women to geek out. You know, mimosas are involved, we talk about anime, we talk about comics, it was just a great time. And that's grown exponentially, which has been really amazing and just been the example of how important and necessary Geek Girl Brunch was in the geek culture.
You know, you finally get to see the person who's writing your story and you see them face to face. I think that was the coolest thing.
Jamila and I have been collaborating since the Straight Outta Gotham project. It showcases the connections between geek and hip-hop culture.
We have two playlists and are now throwing events in Miami. What I love a lot is just the reaction that people share when they see a reference that we share or they see art that we post.
No one can limit what a Black nerd is or looks like or should look like. There are people who love hip-hop and geek culture, and there's nothing crazy about that.
Comics are for everybody, that's how I feel, and I really want people to know that it's more than just the superhero stuff or what they see in Barnes & Nobles, and I wanted to create comics that were by and for women of color. It was important for me to write Wash Day because I wanted to show the beauty of natural hair and highlight that moment of our week where we do our hair.
It was truly one of those things that I can relate to because it's in my culture. When the Wash Day Kickstarter was initiated, it was something that I knew in my heart that was gonna be a beautiful goal because there's so many people that believe in her work.
I only wanted to raise $5,000 for the printing of the comic, but ended up raising over $16,000. And what I was really happy about was that it got press on websites that were not specifically for comics. They were Essence or Ebony or BuzzFeed. That was really exciting for me because I knew I was able to reach an audience that may not be reading comics. And we were able to get Wash Day translated into Spanish.
And to have a Spanish version of that book was touching for me, for the Latino community.
My second comic, Wobble D 3000, is a sci-fi twerking tale. You have to be fit to do it. So I wanted to share that funny experience with others and take it from my point of view and what may be going on through the woman's head when she's twerking.
With certain topics and the writings that she writes, it does touch the people.
I hope by being a Black girl geek icon that other Black and brown women around the world can really stand in their truth and in their passion.
Jamila's work is important because it shows not only what she's capable of, but what Black women are capable of.
The press and attention that my projects have gotten have really been affirming that I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
Geek culture is here to stay and will continue to grow.
She's still putting her stamp down, like, this is my space too, and I'm just gonna kill it how I want.
Don't let, you know, mainstream society deter you from what you care about and what you like.